Hi everyone. Every week I do a networking event, and last week I did a presentation on what we're doing with homeless people and vulnerable people. The presentation was recorded. It'd be great if you could have a listen. It follows on from this and just explains, and it's a bit of makes you think about your situation and how you can help. So please watch the video.
Again, hello everybody. Hope you all had a lovely Christmas and that you managed to spend some, at least some of it, with your family. So I'd like you all to think back to Christmas Day, to sitting down for your Christmas dinner with your turkey and all the trimmings, perhaps pulling some crackers, drinking some wine, then moving into the lounge, lounging in front of the TV, eating chocolates, playing games. Now I'd like you to imagine a very different scene. Same Christmas Day, but this time you've forgotten to cut the pigs in blankets. You get a backhander across the face for being so stupid. Then the gravy's cold, it's lumpy. So you get a fist in the face because now you've ruined Christmas. You're trapped. What do you do? You can't leave, you've got the kids, it's locked down, you've got nowhere else to go. This is the reality for a lot of people on Christmas Day, on any day, and in lockdown especially. Let me think about scenario two with you. No Christmas dinner. No crackers, no wine, no chocolates, no presents. Only a cold, hard pavement, a cardboard box, and some secondhand clothes and a sleeping bag. It's freezing cold, middle of December. It's perhaps started to snow, and you're trying to withdraw yourself even further into that shop doorway to keep warm. It's not a great thought, is it? But unfortunately, this is how a lot of other people spent Christmas Day. And I find that a very, very sobering thought. To put it into perspective, 20% of all recorded crimes during lockdown were listed as domestic abuse. And one in every 207 people in the UK are classed as homeless or in temporary accommodation. Why am I telling you all this? So what we do, we buy houses, like I said before, usually that need work. We renovate them to a standard that is required by social housing and the charities that we work with. And then we hand them over to them so they can give these vulnerable people safe, warm, comfortable homes to live in and help them get their lives back together. How can you help? So firstly, we're struggling to find enough houses. So there's an enormous need for these people, for the housing associations and the charities. So we need to talk directly with people who are thinking about selling, thinking about moving. And unfortunately, in the current situation, people who perhaps can no longer afford the current house they have. They can't afford the mortgage, they can't afford the bills. If we can talk directly to these people, then we can hopefully help them move quicker too, and it helps us get houses quicker. We also need to fund these purchases. So go get a mortgage, everybody says. But the problem with the traditional mortgage system is it doesn't give us the speed or the flexibility that we need to do these things straight away. So what we do is work with private individuals who do a private loan into our business at a fixed rate for 12 months or more if they want. The benefit to that individual is that we will pay them up to 50 times more than they could get in the bank at the moment. Bank rates are potentially going to go into negative interest. It's been like that in Denmark for the last 10 years, so it's not an impossibility. So you'll have to pay to save. But we will give you a fixed return on that. You're also helping others get themselves into a better situation, get back on their feet, and get their lives together, so they aren't vulnerable or suffering anymore. So to give you an idea of what that means in terms of your money, if you have £20,000 as an example, sitting in the bank, or even in one of the ISAs, where the rates are between 0.1% and maybe 1.5%. But if you've got that money in the bank at 0.1%, you will get £20 a year interest on your £20,000. If you invest it in our business to help these vulnerable people, you will get a return of between £800 and £1,000 per year on that money, depending on the project. So you're helping people. You are going to be way, way better off than if your money is sitting there. It's all done through loan agreements that have been written up by solicitors. Depending on the amount you want to invest, there's opportunity for charges. But what I would just say is, please, please talk to us if this is something you're interested in. If you know anybody who might be in that situation where they've got money sitting there, or they've got a house they need to sell, please put them in touch. Because the sooner we can get these houses and get them done up, and these people off the streets or out of a domestic violence situation, the more people we can help. I'm done, but open to any questions that you might have.
We got a little bit of time if anyone does have any questions.
I've got a question. I'd love to connect with you, Jackie, because I'm a property developer.
Cool.
Interesting to maybe have a one-to-one outside of this meeting.
But yeah, absolutely.
But so what percentage do you pay for? So typically, if somebody was to lend you 20,000, what percentage do you pay monthly?
Again, depending on the project, we're normally paying about 4 to 5%, because that way, if we started paying, say, 10% or more, then we would be able to do less projects because of the amount we would have to pay back in the interest. So we tend to do about 4 to 5%, because that means that we can roll more projects out.
And do you sign up the loan agreements through a solicitor?
This loan agreement has been drawn up by solicitors. If we start paying solicitors' fees to put every loan agreement through a solicitor, then again it starts to make things not viable, unless somebody is funding the majority of the project cost.
Yeah.
We always say to people, if you want to go to a solicitor and do it, by all means, you're very welcome to do it. All loan agreements, we get them witnessed, we ask our clients to get them witnessed. If people want a restriction or a charge because they've put in the majority of the cost of the project, that's absolutely fine. We haven't tended to need, or the people that we've worked with haven't been that worried about it, because if I don't pay people back, nobody's ever going to invest with us again. So, I mean, we've raised just over £1 million in private investment in the last 3 years, which sounds a huge amount. Most of that money has been paid back, so it's not like we're sitting on a nice big pot. But like I say, it's down to that know, like, and trust primarily, because that's why I like to talk to people. I'd never just say on the internet, "Oh, just give us your money and off you go." People have to understand where we're coming from and kind of be on the same page, have the same values, and know that they're going to get their money back.
Yeah. All right, thank you.
Jackie, do you have a maximum and a minimum amount that people can invest?
We normally have a minimum of about 10,000, just because of the admin involved with it. Maximum amount, anything anybody's got that they want to invest is absolutely fine, because the more people invest, or the more people that invest, the more projects we can do and the more people we can help.
Sorry, we had a bit of an issue with your microphone at the start there. Oh. Was the what was the practical minimum amount, did you say?
10,000.
10,000. Right. Yeah. Okay. Thank you.